Hello, friends. Laura Whitfield here, your independent Scentsy consultant with Laura's Aroma Retreat. And hold the phone, folks, because I actually have an empties video to share with you. So I have not done one of these in freaking forever, okay? Summer was chaos. And while I was continuously stacking them to the side, I never actually got around to shooting a video. So like it got to the point, okay, that I wasn't using a basket. I was using a 31 large tote to throw these into, thinking that like, oh, eventually I will go back and I will do this right. And it just never happened. So I scrapped all of those during one of my cleanups because I'm like, I don't even remember, right? I don't even remember what I wormed, when I wormed it, what month. Like, I gave up, okay? Things are starting to settle back in a little bit with the kids being back in school, but I still can't seem to catch a week where both of them go to school all the days. So between, you know, going back to school and Nuggy getting sick, and then we had an e-learning day because the school system hates parents, it's cruelty, okay? It is cruelty. Then what else came up? We had parent teacher conference day, so the kids were home today. Like every time I turn around, there's one of them home for something or both of them home. Like I didn't even bother to take Nuggie to preschool today because I'm like, I'm not waking the beast. I'm just not doing it. Like she can miss preschool today because her sister doesn't have to go. So like I have no idea how in this day and age parents are functioning, like with all the days off of school, all of the being sick. Like I know that I worked a traditional gig, right, when Lexi was little, and like I called on my mom a whole lot, right? Like every time I couldn't call off of work or do something, like she had to go to my mom's, but it was no big deal because she lived down the street. Now she lives like 45 minutes away, and if I were to wake up say at like 7 o'clock or 6:30 and find I've got a sick kid at home, like dang, my mom would have to drive 45 minutes out and I'd be late to work anyway. So, and then throw in all of the extra days that they have off, man. Like, I am so stinking grateful for this company and, you know, allowing me to be able to continue to just work from home. So I will, of course, throw the income disclosure statement down on the bottom to keep my butt covered legally. But, you know, this is my livelihood. So that and a combination of the Social Security that the kids get from, you know, my life being on fire. So, all right, let's go ahead and dive into this. We are going to start right out of the gate with what I got warming in my house today because, oh my goodness, I'm so happy to have it back in my house, okay? And if you don't know yet, we now have some lovely bricks that are in our catalog, okay? They are in our catalog. So pumpkin roll, I got my brick of pumpkin roll today. I did put this in my club as my half off. So the nice part about it is that you can either order it directly or you can put it into your club, okay, to get the discount on the brick, which is freaking amazing that they're allowing us to do it either or, right? So I got my first catalog brick of pumpkin roll. And I immediately dove into this sucker today. So it's so good. It's so good. But I will say this, it does have a cinnamon element to it, right? And if you've been watching me for any amount of time, first of all, thank you. If you haven't, hello and welcome. But cinnamon is not my jam. Cinnamon is not my jam. I have a really hard time doing heavy cinnamon scents. And I like pumpkin roll because it's not an overly aggressive cinnamon, but it is still a very predominant cinnamon. And I have to mix it, okay? So I took two cubes out, right? That I cut them into fours. I do it in half here and in half there. And I cut it into fours, so it basically equals, you know, 8 cubes of wax, right? Because I put it through my whole house. But I mixed it with my very favorite mix of all time, which is graham cracker crunch. This is... It's a beautiful, wonderful peanut butter cookie, okay? It's fantastic. And I have no idea, like, why Scentsy did not bring this back to catalog. It is one of my number one bars that people fall in love with, right? Like, think even when they don't like bakery, I'm like, here, you've got to try this one. And the peanut butter in it, like, it's so unique. It's so wonderful. I'm so, sad for everybody that they took it out of the catalog. But this bar is in my monthly club. It's in my monthly club. And I will tell you this, like, I've been getting a bar of it every single month since last fall and winter, right? So what are we, 6-7 months in now? This is the only bar I have, and it's because it came today. So if that tells you anything about how I feel about graham cracker crunch, and I've done a couple events too, so I don't think I warmed through a full 7 bars, but I only had like 1 or 2 at my last event that I did. So pretty much all of the graham cracker crunch is gone to me. But I call this pumpkin peanut butter bread, and it's literally my favorite thing of all times. I did like go live to my community group today and ask for recommendations or things you want to see me try, because I only have the 1 bar. I only have the 1 bar of this, which means that I need to find an equally as loving mix for my darling brick of pumpkin roll that I can do. So like some of the suggestions came through were crumb top, which I have, so I'm definitely gonna give that a go. Probably the number one vote was pumpkin roll with gimme candy to ramp up a little bit of that sweetness and tone down some of that cinnamon for me. So I'm definitely gonna give that a go. And I can't remember what else off the top of my head, but if you guys have suggestions for me, like your favorite mixes for pumpkin roll, I would love to hear them, because me and my bricks are friends. Okay, they're friends. I've got a couple other bricks that I finally finished out. So I've been hoarding my maraschino sugar cookie. I've been hoarding it. My silly self forgot to put it in club before it discontinued. And I'm so sad. Like, I am absolutely freaking heartbroken that I forgot to do this. Now, the only reason that I warmed through the rest of this brick is because a girlfriend of mine still has some. And she's not a super huge fan of it, right? Bakery's not her gig, and that's okay. But I love bakery. And she has offered me her brick of it. So I'm gonna get my brick from her, another fellow Scentsy sister, and I'm just gonna hoard every ounce of it that I can get my hands on at this point, because they didn't bring it to catalog this season. And like, at first I didn't panic. I was like, man, gosh darn it, I wish I'd remembered to do that or not mess that up. And like, I don't know how I messed that up, truthfully. Like, I could swear to goodness it was in there at some point, but it's not in there. And it makes me so sad. But either which way, I really thought it was like a shoo-in to come to the catalog, right? Like, they always bring a brick from the holiday collection traditionally. I thought this one was going in, and they're mean and they didn't do it. And I need everybody to yell at home office to bring it back. So there's that. And then the other one that I finished out was pink apple and nectarine from our spring and summer collection. Because I live in the Midwest here in Indiana, like, our weather is severely bipolar, okay? Severely bipolar. For the last several days, it has been 80s, like 80 degrees. We went to the apple orchard over the weekend, right? Because, man, a fall activity is like, my calendar is booked. My calendar is booked for October, whether it's vendor events or family commitments like Nucky's birthday, like you name it, the day is booked, okay? For one thing or another. But so this past weekend was literally the only weekend that I had the opening to go do the apple orchard with the kids. So here I am, okay, and one of my very good girlfriends who I met through Scentsy came with us, and we did the day at the orchard, and we're in this corn maze, right? And it's like 92 degrees. I am sweating from every nook and cranny of my body. I'm just pouring sweat because in the corn maze, right, like there's no shade. It's just direct sun beating down on you the whole time. My kids are in shorts and a tank top running through the corn maze, and I'm like, where is my fall? Like, it is October. It is October. I guess it was really the end of September, but like, come on. It's time. It's time, Mother Nature. And today, like, I've had the air conditioning on for the last several days still, because it's been 80 plus something. It was like 84, 85 here today, and it was hot and crazy and muggy, and I'm not enjoying it at all. at all. But tomorrow's supposed to be 64, so, you know, we're just going to drop 25 degrees or 20 degrees, and we'll see how many of us get sick. That's really where I'm at, like the rapid drop in temperature. I'm like, thanks. We're just going to rip the rug right underneath. But in honor of the heat, I did the rest of the pink apple and nectarine. This was my favorite spring and summer brick from this past summer. It's just got this like creamy citrusy thing going on to it that I really thoroughly enjoyed. So that was a good one. Okay. What do we have in here? I went through a laundry system of Fiji flour. I love Fiji flour. I love Fiji flour and all the things. I just do. So finished out a laundry system in Fiji flour. I think I finished out fluffy fleece before that, but it was in the scrap. And then I just got in white amber and teak. So that will be my next one once I finish my currently open Fiji flower that I'm working on. So, you know, I have my things. All right. So diving in to the basket of empties. And again, weather has been severely bipolar. I have a good mix of stuff in here between like spring and fruity and summer, and then a couple of fall and winter things. So first bar out is Happy Birthday. This is Indeed in my club. It is just this beautiful vanilla cake. It was part of the last Bring Back My Bar. I was so excited that I got to get my hands on it before Scentsy did an update to Bring Back My Bar and has officially eliminated anything that's been voted back in like the last, it's like 3 to 5 years. I forget what it is, but to make sure that like it's not even up for voting if it has been voted back anytime recently, so that we can fall in love with new scents and my club can get even bigger than it already is, right? Because that's gonna happen. I did a bar of frosted cinnamon roll. This is September's scent of the month. This is a gorgeous, beautiful, strong performing bakery. The cinnamon in it is a little aggressive for me. I'm not going to lie. I like this more in an open space, right? Because I use this at an event that I was doing. And like when you open it up and there's airflow and there's breeze and all of that, like I can tolerate it just fine. But it's a lot for me. It's a lot of cinnamon for me. So would I recommend it? Absolutely. But I need to mix it with like a vanilla bean buttercream to bring that cinnamon note down for myself. So there's that. I did a bar of wildflower cotton. I'm pretty sure that I put this in the big room. And I really love this. Like, it's a really clean, like, laundry type scent with just that tiny itty bitty hint of floral in it that I don't find offensive. Like, it's not overly powdery because you get more of that clean linen in it than anything else. And it's just, it's lovely. I love it in the big room because it's such a strong performer. I also really like it in my bedroom because it's clean and it's comforting. Let's see. I did a bar of Fall Into Love. I'm not in love with it. I'm just not, okay? It has a green note to it. It's green. It is like slightly fall-esque, but mostly I get that green plant note. And it's not like a full-on mashed, like stems, like kind of thing. But it is very distinctly green, and it's not my gig. Did a bar of blackcurrant bubbly. I know I did this one in the big room. This one is the where I tend to put it. This in the girls' room. Haley really likes this too. And I've been getting this for over 3 years now, and I'm still never sad to have it in my warmers. It smells like a screwball. It's amazing. Let's see, Frightfully Delightful. Oh my goodness, you guys. Okay, if you have not put this in your club, run, go put it in your club. They're not repouring anymore. Club is the only way that you can get it. And it's fantastic. It is fantastic. It has gimme candy vibes, okay? But it is significantly toned down on the cloying sweetness of it, right? Like, it is perfect. It's perfect in every way. It's this gorgeous caramelized pumpkin type thing that I have to have in my life forever and ever. It's already in my club. I already put 2 bars a month in my club because I have to have this. I do. I have to have this bar. It's amazing. Okay. Next up is Forever Fall. And I love the packaging on this one, you guys. All the cute little pumpkins and the leaves. And I think it's amazing, right? I think they classified this as citrus because there's, I think there's orange in here. But I love this. You get the really like, you get that smell of the fall leaves when they're first starting to turn. Like they're not yet quite all on the ground, right? There's still that little bit of freshness and that little bit of life to them. But you can, like, it's, you can smell it, right? Like when the leaves start to turn, you can smell fall rolling in. And it's so good. It's so good. But it's not a full-on, like, it's not painted leaves, right? Painted leaves is this crunchy fall leaf, like when you're walking through and it's slightly damp and you get that, like, it's a very distinct smell. This is as fall is approaching. As the leaves are starting to turn, you still got that crisp, fresh air. It's just starting to get cool. It's to die for. We're all mad here. I will never get sick of this bar. I really, like, I will not ever get sick of this bar. It is a really, like, tart, deep, sweet, fruity, like, plum going on. Oh, it's so good. Let's see what else we got. Monstropolis. Okay. Hold on. Oh, that's not it. I just put you in there. Where did you fall? Okay, so Monstropolis and We're All Mad Here are very similar to each other. I would say We're All Mad Here is the fall version of Monstropolis. Monstropolis has that same zingy, citrusy note to it, but there is something deeper and more rich about We're All Mad Here. Where this one is more zingy and more playful and more summer-esque. Like, I love them. I love them to pieces. Oh, and they're such good performers, right? Like, a lot of the time, the Disney bars are on the light side, right? They're on the light side or they're on the floral side. And these are just, they're fantastic. They're absolutely fantastic. Speaking of light Disney bars, womp womp, the Dance in Autumn. So this was from the Frozen 2 Wax Collection, which came out before I joined Scentsy, right? So, like, this is before my time, which kind of makes me sad because I really want that dang Frozen 2 warmer. It's gorgeous. One of these days, I will find it somewhere and I will add it to my collection. But this was supposed to be, like, a fall crispy type leaves one, and I had picked up, I think I picked up, like, 5 or 6 of them in a flash sale. I can barely smell it. I can barely smell it in my warmers. I can barely smell it in the bar. It's a womp womp for me. Oh, well. Can't win them all. I did do some red berries and spruce the other day. This is an old juicy bar. This one was actually gifted to me from my friend here on YouTube, Catherine King. She is an amazing woman. If you've not checked her out, make sure you go check her out. But she sent me some, like, a stash of, quite a while ago, to be honest with you. And I'm slowly working my way through some of the things that she sent me. She was just kind enough to share some of the bars with me, and red berries and spruce is one of them. This is one of my all-time favorite, like, spruce pine bars, because it's got that, like, sweet cranberry and something else in it. I don't even remember, man, but it's so good. It's so good. It is in my club, too, but, like, yummy. Okay. The next bar out is gingerbread buttercream. I feel like I mixed this with something. I had a partial of ginger. Oh, I did. I did. So I had 2 partials. I had a partial of gingerbread buttercream and I had a partial of Hug-A-Mug. And I put these two together because, like, the gingerbread in this, it's kind of aggressive. It's kind of an aggressive spice note to me personally. Like, it's not bad, but it's not my favorite, right? So I threw in a partial bar of Hug-A-Mug. Which is that, again, another freaking one that I never would have imagined that they would take away, right? Like, Hug-A-Mug is one of my favorites. And one of my favorite mixers. I guess I don't melt it too much on its own. But it went phenomenal with warm pumpkin drizzle. Very good. And another one I'm kicking myself. Like, warm pumpkin drizzle, I gave it the cut. Because I'm like, oh, it's coming back. It's fine. It didn't. So, anyways, I mixed these two together to tone down the cinnamon and the gingerbread buttercream or the spice. I don't even know if it's cinnamon. But it was a good combination. It was a good combination. I don't know. It's something that I would, like, it's not a ride or die combo. It's not a ride or die mixer for me. But it was really good. And like I said, I really like Hug and Mug as a mixer. So it's okay. I'll find new things to mix. I did a bar of candy cane buttercream in my kitchen. I did this the other day, not because I was craving it, but because my sister was like, well, I wonder how this one warms, right? She's like, I've looked at it and I like the way it smells in the bar, but I just don't know if it's going to be like too much mint in my home. And she was here with my nephew and the kids were playing and we were hanging out and doing whatever. I don't know what we were doing, but I put this in the kitchen so that she could actually experience how it warms. And it's very strong on cold. It is not as strong in your warmers. Like, it comes down really quickly. I mean, it does come out of the gate like a gangbuster, but it doesn't stay super, super strong. So it ends up really nicely moving through that mint and down to more just like that buttercream note with just a hint of the coolness in it. So that's a good one. It's not seasonal for me, but you know. This one I just made samples with. So this is all blacks. I think it is actually still available with the rest of the rugby collection. This is a really masculine, manly fragrance, but it smells like soap to my nose, which I'm not a fan of, right? Like, I don't, like, I love a good manly, masculine scent, but I like it to be more woodsy and not so soapy. But in my Happy Meal packages, okay, in some of my Happy Meal packages, I found the most adorable silicone mold at Michael's, which, like, I love the Wilton molds, right? Like the candy molds, and they were bats. It was a bat mold. So I had, this was the only black wax bar that I had. And I'm like, I'm going to sample this just because I'm that giant nerd who's like, I have black bat wax samples. So that's what I did. I sampled it. I had a lot of people really like it, right? My sister, my other sister being one of them. I have a lot of sisters, five of them. But my other sister is a huge fan of it. I'm going to be honest though, like the more I smell this, the more I get Oogie Boogie Roll of the Dice, like that B.O. undertone. Leia, what are you doing? No, get out of whatever you do. Leia, come here. Yeah, knock it off. You're in mischief mode, young lady. And Mama says no. That's the puppers. Let's see. There, puppy pie. Say hi. Say hi. Yeah. Okay, that's not quite what I had in mind. But that's a good one. Yeah, okay. I didn't mean climbing my lap. Here, you want to sniff some wax? You want to sniff? You want to smell? Do you like it? Yeah, I don't like it either, right? Like, it's got that roll of the dice B.O. undertone, I think. And, like, it's just, it's not my jam. But my sister loves it. My sister Julie loves it. And she's like, I'm going to need some of that. So, oh, okay. I'm going to get the dog down and I'll come back. Okay, I am back. I had gotten a phone call in that I had to take. So, all right, let's dive back into the basket, even though my brain is now completely off the track that it was on. But it's fine. It happens. So, okay. Next up, did a bar of lavender cotton. This is fresh and clean and just slightly lavender, more cotton than lavender. And it is a fantastic performer in wax. Unfortunately, again, another one that Scentsy cut the cord on. Like, why do they? I know we can't have all the things, right? Like, we can't keep all the things, but I wish we could. So, okay. Did a bar of Rustic Lodge. I love this. Love, 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 love. It's absolutely perfect. It has got that smoky note, like around the campfire, but also that wooded note. That is amazing. What else do we have? Oh, apple cherry strudel. So this was the bar that busted in my unboxing video, right? Like, you can still see, like, it was super, super stuck in there. I don't know if you guys have gotten bars like that lately, but they must have done something with a pour where, like, it was just in there good. It was in there very good. And oh, it's so good. It's yummy. It's a one day and done, right? Like, and I don't even care. Like, I'm not even mad about it that it is literally one day and done. So it's this gorgeous cherry apple mixture with like that slight hint of that bakery in it. Oh, it's so good. It's so worth it every time. Did a bar of Dumbo Circus Parade. This was likely upstairs in the girls' room. And this one is returning on Monday. I'm so excited. I think I am going to get me the Dumbo Buddy. I skipped out on it the last time. And like I kept waiting for it to come to clearance. And waiting for it to come to clearance. And waiting. And it didn't, right? It did not ever come to clearance. And now we know why. So Scentsy, as I'm sure you know by this point, is the official sponsor of the Dumbo ride at Walt Disney World, which is awesome. Like, we're getting our name up on the marquee. There's a whole new fragrance experience coming to Walt Disney World. Like, I want to go check it out so bad. I really do. Like, I want to go see Smell-O-Fants on parade. But in honor of that, we are getting a brand new Dumbo fragrance, which I will tell you, this Soar High is not, like, I think this bar, Dumbo Circus Parade, is better than the new fragrance that is coming in the brick, okay? But that one is very heavy citrus. It's got a lot of pineapple in it. I'm not a pineapple fan. This is a light citrus with a very creamy vanilla that comes very forward. Oh, I'm telling you guys, Dumbo has been in my club from day one. From the inception of the club, Dumbo has been in there. And now is your chance to get your hands on the Dumbo bar and add it to yours. So do that. It is amazing. Cranberry candy cane. Okay, this is from the new holiday collection that just came out. I am sadly not impressed. I'm just going to be honest. I have not gotten a chance to warm the other bars yet. That vanilla barnwood, though, I can already tell you, it is fantastic. This, it smells really good and cold. I did put this into my kitchen the other day to test it out. Because, of course, we get our early access bars. I use it to make some samples. I had, you know, a partial bar left over. I put it into my kitchen. It did not last. It really did not last. It's pleasant, right? Like, it wasn't a bad smell. It's not a powerhouse by any stretch of the imagination. It is definitely on the light side, in my personal opinion. But I like really heavy. God, what happened? I itched myself more than I thought. I haven't gotten my nails done in quite a while. I let them come off over the summer, right? Because I just kind of ran out of time, like kid-free time, to go and get them done. And I just haven't gone back since, even though the kids are back in school. So they scratch more than I thought they did. But okay, so yeah, this did not perform well for me. I could barely smell it in my warmers in the kitchen, and that cranberry really disappeared quite quickly. And the peppermint really wasn't strong enough. Like if you were to take like Very Merry Cranberry and Perfect Peppermint, right? Like, I think you can get the same concept, but a whole lot stronger. Now, if you're one of those people who doesn't like really strong fragrances, you don't like it in your face, maybe it's headache inducing for you, I think you would be okay with this bar. It just didn't perform for me the way that I wanted it to at the end of the day. Dutch apple bread. I did do a bar of that. I know, don't hate me, don't be jealous, because this is sold out over and over and over again. It's gorgeous. It's gorgeous. It is the perfect amount of apple. Like, it is a really crisp golden apple, right? Like an apple, like, it's not Mac apple, right? It's apple pie apple. And I'm trying to think of what the name of that is. Like a Granny Smith, or I don't know. I don't bake. I don't bake. But I know there's a certain apple. It's that apple. It's a bakery apple specifically. And it's got that little bit of tartness. Definitely distinctly sweetness on the apple. And just that slight, slight undertone of like that bakery bread, right? Like fresh bread out of the oven. It's delicious. And I love apple bread. I do. I really love apple bread, and I love pumpkin bread. Like, they're amazing. Did a bar of Moana, Spirit of Motunui. This one is also in my club. And it's just tropical. It's tropical and it's fun. And I enjoy every minute of it. This is a bar that I will let sit for a while, though. Like, I don't immediately melt it when it comes in. Like, this is a bar that has to cure for a while for it to have any sort of strength. So when they do a fresh pour on these and send it in my club, I know I'm not going to get big performance out of it. So it's one of those ones that needs to sit for a bit. Did a bar of Crumb Top. love it. It's so good. It's so good. Hey, let's take a look at the brick next to the crumb top bar and see how they might smell next to each other. We'll do both and see if maybe that'll tone some stuff down. Hold on. I can see this working. I can see that. Whoa, my brick is falling out. Ah, being attacked. I could see that working. I can see that like buttery brown sugar thing that Crumb Top has got going on. And don't, like, I know Crumb Top can be used as a mixer, right? Like, I'm well aware that a lot of people like to use Crumb Top as a mixer. I love Crumb Top all on its own. It's got a really good, like, rich butter note to it, but that brown sugar really gives it like this perfect amount of sweetness, so it's not like a popcorn butter. Oh, it's so good. But we'll do that next. We'll try some Crumb Top with pumpkin roll next, because I could see that being really good together. Not my bar, but Haley did a bar of bubblegum. She loves this stinking bar. She loves this bar so much, right? Like, bubblegum is in my quarterly club, okay? And it is her bar, right? Like, it is absolutely Haley's bar. And, like, my clubs came today, right? Like I was telling you earlier. And I had both of my clubs run, both my quarterly and my monthly. It was their overlapping month. And, like, I open the box, and right out of the gate, Haley grabs bubblegum right off the top. I'm like, what are the odds that bubblegum was, like, the last bar that they packed? And she knows it. She freaking knows it. She knows the shade of the color. She knows what the front looks like. Like, I don't even know why I bother putting a sticker on these, because it never leaves my house. It never makes it out of my house, because Haley will seek out bubblegum. And, like, it's in her warmer now, right? Her new bar of bubblegum came. She wanted it in her warmer. And, the girls were so funny, right? Like, the club came in. And I got my little tiny human vultures, okay? I'm opening up this box, and I'm trying to, like, separate and sort some stuff and whatever, right? Because I've got a couple, we had bars in there for customers too, right, that they wanted and whatever. So anyways, yeah, they were trying to, like, walk off with stacks of wax. Like, literally, they were using their face to hold the stack of wax. And they're like, I'm like, where are you going? They're like, our room. I'm like, no, you're not. Get back. That's 12 bars of wax. No, pick one. You can have one. Fine. They picked bubblegum. Mm-hmm. Every time. Every time it comes in, it goes right in the warmers. Oh, look, another bar, Frightfully Delightful. Shocker. Again, I bought a 6-pack of this right out of the dang gate. I knew I was going to need that in my life a lot. It's fine. I didn't even sample that bar because I knew it was going to sell out. Like, I didn't even bother to sample it because I knew it was just gone, right? We did a bar of Cutie Pie Cupcake, probably in the kitchen. That is my go-to place for this. It is clementine and rich vanilla cake batter. Oh, it's so amazing. It is amazing. And then I do have Fearless by Nature in here. This was a partial bar also sent to me by Catherine King. Like I said, I dove into that box this week and started pulling some stuff out. This is such a good performer, you guys. This is woodsy. It's this gorgeous woodsy sage type of scent. It reminds me a little bit of citrus and sage, but with a little less citrus and a little more sage, which I'm fine with the balance. And it is not in my club. I did not keep it in my club, but oh, I love it every time. It's such a good bar. But not everything can stay, right? And I found even when it was in my club, like, I have to be in the mood for this particular bar. And I find that I don't reach for it on the regular, right? Like, I just have, it's one of those that I really have to be craving to put it in. But it does last for days. It lasts for days and days. And it's so good. Okay, I only have, it appears, 1 pack of pods in here. I will be honest with you, I've been a little lax on swapping out some of my pods. And I think, truthfully too, like, I think I threw them into the discard bin that I got rid of a couple weeks ago when I was changing them out, because this basket was also full. And I didn't set it there. I think I just threw it into the discard bin. But these came from my air purifier in my bedroom, okay? And I know that for a fact because it has two discontinued pods. It has vanilla mint, right? Which I have a hoard of in pods, but I use them exclusively in my bedroom. Because that's where I like the mint. And that's where I like eucalyptus and sage and all of the sinus clearing fragrances and the most calming fragrances, right? Like I like the fun things throughout the main level and I like calming and clearing in my bedroom. And then I replaced it with snow-kissed cranberry. So again, picked them up in a flash sale, stuck them in my air purifier when I changed out the filter, which was nasty. You guys, like dust bunnies would be falling off of that thing. I didn't keep it this time. I know I showed it to you the last time and you could see all the little dust bunnies, but like I didn't want to take it back out of the box and re-enter all that crap into my air. So I just left it alone. So that, my friends, is everything that I have for you on this round. And until next time, I'll catch y'all later. Bye-bye.